Connecting your Gmail to HubSpot is a great way to track your emails, plus there's a lot of bonus features that go with it. Let's go over how to set up HubSpot in Gmail using the Chrome extension and how to track your communications.
Welcome to HubSpot Hacks, where we help you get more out of HubSpot.
Not only can HubSpot track the emails that you send and receive, but you can also use it to insert trackable links and attach those to specific contact records inside HubSpot according to the contacts you had in Gmail. To do all this, we need to set up HubSpot in Gmail, so let's go ahead and dive in. So to get started, you're going to need to add the Chrome extension inside of Gmail. So we'll go to Preferences. Depending on when you're watching this video, how to get to extensions in the Chrome store may change, but you're going to head to the Chrome store to find the HubSpot sales extension. So let's go there right now. So in the store, you're going to search for HubSpot. Now HubSpot has a couple of different extensions, so you want the one that says HubSpot sales, and I'm going to click Add to Chrome and add that extension. It's going to check for a little bit here, and then it's been added. It has this little sprocket looking icon here in the top. So you're going to go ahead and activate that. To do that, you're going to need to log into your HubSpot account. So if you're setting this up, you do need to have a HubSpot account in order for this to work. And it's going to ask me to log in, so I'll do that. Now, when it's live, the icon is going to be this orange color, and choose the HubSpot account that is yours. If you only have one account, that's the one that it will go with. Once you get logged in, you'll see that this is live. So I'm going to go back to my Gmail. And in your Gmail, when I compose a message, you'll see that it's going to look a little bit different than it did before. You'll see that it's actually enabled now because I have this bar that sits right under this composition area of the to and the subject. You'll also notice it. So there's this orange circle at the top. When it's got this little green dot, it's enabled. When it's not, it's going to have a gray dot and you'll be asked to log in. But if you look at this over here, there's a little sprocket as well. So that it shows that it's integrated. Now to show you what this can do, so I'm going to type a contact in here. I'm going to send an email to Jason. And since Jason's a part of my team, I actually can't log his email into HubSpot. So there's a feature that we'll show you in a different video that actually shows you how to not track all those emails back and forth to your coworkers. So I'll send an email actually to somebody else, and I'm gonna send an email to Lindsay. So here it's gonna ask me if I wanna log it and track it, so I can. And the subject here, I'm just gonna say hello. But let's say I wanna use a template. So I can actually use a template inside of HubSpot. So when you're in HubSpot, you'll set up all these different templates, and this Chrome extension allows you to use the templates that you've built inside of HubSpot. So let's say I wanted to share a helpful resource. I go in here, here's the link, and then I can go ahead and send. So I'm gonna actually show you a different one. I'm gonna send to my personal address so I can show you how this works. I'm gonna say hi. I won't use a template, it's just hello, test message. I'm gonna go ahead and send that and click send. So I'm going to open that email on my personal account here so you can see that if someone gets the email on their phone, what's going to happen? Maybe give it just a couple seconds. Okay, so I've got the email on my phone. I'm going to go ahead and click in here and open it. So now if I go into HubSpot and I click into contacts and I refresh this. Now keep in mind the person that I just emailed was not in HubSpot before, so you'll see that it automatically added that person according to their email address. So sometimes it can guess the first name and last name, sometimes it doesn't, but you'll see that this contact record is now in HubSpot from just the email that I sent. So how great is that? You don't have to actually go in and add the person in, it will automatically log it. Now if this person happened to respond, so if I respond to this email, if you go into your Chrome extension up here, you can see that I opened this email. So again, you're tracking how people are interacting with your email. And since I did have this live on my account before I took it off and showed you back how to do this, you'll see that there's a lot of other activity that I can just log in here and see who's opened the email, how they've interacted with it, and it makes it really quick and easy. Now again, if I responded here to this email, so it comes back, and here I have this tracked and opens one. If I wanted to update this contact record, I have this little widget over on the right-hand side. I can actually edit this record that is in HubSpot right here in my Gmail dashboard, which is awesome. So let's say I knew the job title was VP of sales. The company name was, you know, XYZ company. and I can update various pieces of information right that goes right into the HubSpot CRM right here in Gmail. So that's it. That's quick and easy. That's the Chrome extension enabled. If you're going to take it a step further, I encourage you to get the HubSpot mobile app that can help you figure out who's opening your emails and interacting with them there as well. Thanks for watching. For more HubSpot hacks, tips, and how-tos, make sure and subscribe to this channel. We'll have a new video coming at you every single week. If you have topics or questions you want us to address in future videos, drop a comment below. We read every single comment and we'll make sure to get that in a future episode.